Welcome back to my channel. My name is Gabby. If you're new here, and as you can tell by today's title, the video is going to be chatting about my Everywhere belt bag. I've gotten a lot of questions on social media and on YouTube about this bag, so I wanted to do a little review for you guys and show you what I keep in my bag. This is going to be a real look of what is inside here right now because I have not cleaned it out, but I also wanted to give you guys a review on the Everywhere belt bag. I know that Lululemon is a little bit pricey, but I just wanted to show you guys, in my opinion, that it is worth the money. And just as a disclaimer, yes, I do work for Lululemon, but this is my opinion and my personal thoughts. It does not reflect the company. I will link everything that I can down below for you guys as well in case you want to shop. But without further ado, let's jump right into it. To be honest, at first, I definitely was not a fanny pack person. I absolutely hated the idea of a fanny pack, but I did go into Lululemon frequently, and that's what all of the educators and key leaders wear on the floor. And I thought, hey, that looks pretty cute. And so I finally decided to purchase one, and it has honestly been one of the best purchases of my entire life. Maybe that's a little dramatic, but I promise. It has been a great purchase. Okay, so this is my Everywhere belt bag. I got the color Spiced Chai. They honestly have so many colors on the website right now that I'm sure you could find a color that you like and that works for you. I definitely gravitate towards the more neutral colors because I think that's just more versatile and goes with everything. But I decided to pick up Spiced Chai, and honestly, I still wear it with everything. It is still a very like neutral color. It is the perfect kind of pink mauve, and I absolutely adore it. I have not taken this thing off basically since I got it, which was a few months ago now, and honestly, I do not regret this purchase at all. I highly recommend it. So this bag is 1 liter in volume size, which is actually quite spacious. I used to carry a purse, and I think it should be around like 1 or 2 liters, I'm pretty sure. But I found myself just throwing a whole bunch of stuff in there, and things always got lost in my purse. But with this one, I love how organized you can keep it. There's enough pockets for everything. So it does have the kind of little clasp here. I don't know, buckle clasp, I guess. Is that what these are called? I'm not sure. But this makes it super easy if you wanted to wear it as a belt to take on and off. And then it has the adjustable strap as well, so you could wear it cross body or around your waist as a belt. And I love the versatility of that. I think it can really, you know, give off a different look depending on the way you wear it. I know some people also wear it as a purse, which is also just fine. But for me, the reason I got this bag was kind of to eliminate the dangly purse thing by my side, which this does. I also love that it's hands-free, and yes, like technically a purse could be hands-free too, but in the sense that, I mean, something's not like hitting your side as you walk everywhere. This one is really close to you, so there's like no movement with it, and that's something I really enjoy. So now getting into it, there is one zippered pocket back here that is able to hold a whole bunch of stuff, and as you can see, I have my mask, as we still have to wear masks at work or whenever we go into a Lululemon store property, etc. So I still have my mask. This is just the Ear Loop one in Lavender Dew. I find these ones really comfortable and breathable, so these are definitely my go-to pick right now for masks while we still have to wear them. And I also keep my little, what do you call this, like an adapter thing for your phone, because Apple no longer has headphone adapters. They no longer come with chargers, all that fun stuff that we're not gonna get into. But of course, you have to carry around all these little silly accessories now. But I do keep that back there, so it is nice and secure, and it's not gonna get lost, because the only other thing I keep in there is my mask, so I know when I take it in and out and to watch for that. And then this is kind of the inside of the bag here. You can see that there's lots of room in here to keep other things. Some people like to keep cash and stuff in there, but I don't usually carry cash at all. But that is a very useful pocket. And now into the main compartment here. I love the zipper. I think it's super, I don't know, nice. It's a nice hardware piece. It's not like super flimsy or anything, or like a tassel that could fall off or fray or anything like that. So I really like the metal tassel. It also has the Lululemon kind of symbol logo in the inside on a metal plate, which looks really nice. And then of course the Lululemon symbol on the outside, which I really like as well. I think it just adds like a nice detail to it. But this is a look inside of the bag. Again, I have another mask here. This one is now dirty that I forgot to take out, but this is kind of a quick look of what I keep in my bag. As you can see, there's two mesh pockets right here and then one longer mesh pocket on this side. So the first thing I keep in here are obviously my car and house keys. Can't really go anywhere without those. That's the first thing I keep in here. The second thing, I keep some hand sanitizer. I never used to keep hand sanitizer in my bag, but again, with the pandemic, just having it on the go is not a bad thing. So, you know, just your standard Purell hand sanitizer. Not really much I can say about that. Any hand sanitizer will do, but it does fit into this pocket like so nicely. It's like the perfect size. So, I really enjoy that. The other thing I have in here is just a small thing of L'Occitane hand lotion. I believe you can get this at Sephora. This was gifted to me for Christmas a while ago, and I like just having a small tube of hand cream in my bag, so in case my hands ever get dry. I like to have this when I'm on the go. I also have a lip chap. This is the Soft Lips Vanilla Lip Chap. I really like these ones because they have SPF as well. So sometimes you forget about your lips with SPF protection, but with this lip chap, you know, you're covered. And I really, really like the smell of it. So these have been my go-to lip chaps for a very long time. And of course, I just have my AirPods in here as well in case I want to listen to music on the go. But nothing fancy about this one. This is like literally the first gen non-charging, non-fancy Apple headphones, but they work for me and they're just fine. So that's what I keep in those two little pockets. In the main pocket, I just have some receipts. Awesome. And I have a couple of gift cards in here to Shoppers Drug Mart, which is just like a drugstore in Canada. And then just like one of these ultimate dining card things. It's for like a whole bunch of different restaurants that you could use it for. And I also have my wallet key pouch thing. I'm not really sure what you call this. They used to come with gift cards at Lulu a long time ago. I don't think they hand them out anymore, unfortunately. They discontinued them, but I have a few laying around from past gift cards, which I have now taken up to use as a mini wallet. And then I just keep all my ID, debit card, credit cards, stuff like that in here, and a couple of other gift cards. Yeah, really like nothing that exciting. As you can see, there's just cards in there, but I think this is like the perfect size to just stick in your bag, have on the go. It really makes you think what you're carrying in your wallet, because my last wallet, I just had a plethora of membership cards and stuff that I never use. So I got rid of all of those, and honestly, it's so much lighter and so much easier to find things. I also have an app on my phone called StowCard to put all my membership cards onto my phone, so it's super easy and I don't have to carry around the physical cards anymore. So that is great, and that is actually all I keep in my Everywhere belt bag. As you can see now, it is empty. I'll give you a better look of the inside of it. I love these mesh pockets, keeps it super organized, but you're also able to see what's in the pocket, which is really great. So, you know, nothing's getting lost in there. This is what it looks like, completely empty, pretty flat. Yeah, I think these bags are really versatile, whether, you know, you're going to the gym and you just want to throw your phone, your keys, and your wallet in here. If you're going for taking your dog for a walk, a lot of people use it for that as well. You can stick little dog treats in the back, or, you know, the poop bag thing. I don't know what else you take on a dog walk. I don't have a dog, but whatever your essentials you need could probably fit in here to walk your dog. I also think it'd be really great for traveling. If you have like a larger backpack that you have to put in the overhead, you could keep all of your essentials in here, like a charger, your passport, your phone, headphones, gum, etc. I think it would all fit in here. My iPhone 11 does fit in here quite nicely, however, I'm using it to film, so unfortunately I can't really show you, but take my word for it, an iPhone 11 fits perfectly in here. I think the 12s are probably the same size, so you're safe there. It does fit a lot of other things regardless, so I just love the versatility of this bag that you could really use it for anything and everything, and that makes it 100% worth it to me. Early on, a lot of people did complain about the quality of the zipper of the belt bags. They felt it really stuck, like it was hard to zip open, but as you can like hear, it slides pretty easily. So on this one, it has not been a problem. I have not had a problem at all with the zipper. Sometimes it might get caught in like this extra little flap here. So you just have to like be mindful when you're zipping to like keep the zipper straight and you don't have problems there. Same with the back one. I've never had a problem with this zipper either. There is like a little bit of fraying like here, but that's just because I think I've like worn it and rubbed it a little bit. You could just like cut this tiny little thread off. I don't even think you can see it. So that's honestly not a problem. This is super easy to clean as well, by the way. All you do is take like a little bit of dish soap or a very mild soap, like baby shampoo or something, and you can just wet it on a cloth and very gently wipe away any spills or stains on here. And then I just go over it again with a little bit of water to make sure the soap residue is off, and then leave it to dry, and boom, it looks brand new. So that's super awesome. I love the material of these. Not all of the materials are the same though. I feel like some are a little bit more slippery. This one's a little bit more like fabric-y, if that makes sense. All in all, like, it's still a great product. These retail for $38 Canadian. I think it will be very similar in the US, and I'll have that link down below for you guys. But honestly, this has been a game changer for me. I cannot imagine my life without it now. I don't think I can go back to a purse. I just love the versatility of this. It will be great if you're in college and you need to go out. It's great if you're not in college and you need to go out. You just keep all of your essentials close to you. You know, less chance of you losing things, I think. And it really makes you mindful of what you're carrying around every day, which I really, really enjoy. I love the hands-free portion of it and just, you know, not having to worry about my purse dangling by my side or keeping track of that, having something bulky. This is just, you know, it's a really good investment. I highly recommend it. So that is my opinion on these belt bags. Let me know yours down in the comments. Do you have one? Do you like it? And if you don't, are you thinking about picking one up? That is going to be all for the video today. I hope you guys found this helpful. If you did, remember to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you're new here, because I have so much Lululemon content coming your way and I would love to have you around. Hit that notification bell so that you're notified when those things do post. And with that, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.